Hi friends, today we'll see 7th August 2018 current affairs. First one is May 3, 2018. India and Thailand joint military exercise. It is held in Thailand from 6 to 19 August 2018 and it will be a planton level exercise that comprises of infantry component. Next one is government launches bidder information management system and Bhumi Rashi with linkage FPMS linkage portals. It was launched by Union Ministry of Road Transport and Highways and it is aimed at expediting pre-construction processes relating to bidding and land acquisition respectively. BIMS portal aims at streamlining process of pre-qualification of bidders for engineering procurement construction mode of contracts for national highway works with enhanced transparency and objectivity. Bhumi Rashi portal developed by Ministry of Road Transport and Highway and National Informatics Centers. It comprises entire revenue data of country right down to 6.4 lakh villages. Bhumi Rashi portal integrated with public financial management system to facilitate payment related to compensation for land acquisition to all beneficiaries directly through Bhumi Rashi system. Third one is Xingkong 2. China successfully tested first hypersonic aircraft. It's tested its first cutting-edge hypersonic wave rider flight vehicle. Here, wave rider is flight vehicle that flies in atmosphere and uses the shock waves generated by its own hypersonic flight with the air to glide at high speed. It is designed by state-run China Academy of Aerospace Aerodynamics in collaboration with China Aerospace Science and Technology Cooperation. It has capability to penetrate any current generation anti-missile defense system. During the test, it had reached 30 kilometers in altitude at Mach 5.526 speed. Currently, United States and Russia have been carrying out similar experiments. Next one is Parliament passes Criminal Law Amendment Bill 2018. The bill amends Indian Penal Code, Civil Procedure Code, Prevention of Child Sexual Offence Act and Indian Evidence Act. It provides stringent punishment of minimum 20 years. It can be extended to imprisonment for rest of life or life imprisonment or death for rape of girl less than 12 years. It increases minimum punishment for 10 years to 20 years for a crime of rape of girl under 16 years. And it can be extended to imprisonment for rest of life. It also increases minimum punishment for rape of woman from rigorous imprisonment of 7 years to 10 years, which can be extended to life imprisonment. And it said about speedy investigation and trial must be completed in 2 months. Proposes 6-month time limit for disposal of appeals in rape cases. Next one is Parliament passes bill to provide constitutional status to National Commission for Backward Class. The Parliament has passed Constitution 123rd Amendment Bill 2017. Now the bill will be sent to President for his assent as per 368 of Constitution. It empowers President to specify socially and educationally backward classes in various states and union territories in consultation with Governor of concerned state. Next one is Lok Sabha passed SC and ST Prevention of Atrocities Amendment Bill 2018. The bill was passed because to reverse the effects of Supreme Court order concerning certain safeguards against arrest under SC/ST law. The bill states that investigating officer will not require approval of any authority for arrest of accused. Preliminary inquiry will not be required for registration of first information report against person accused under this act. The act states that persons accused of committing offence under Act cannot apply for anticipatory bail. Next thing is Startup India launches Startup Academia Alliance program. It is to promote spirit of entrepreneurship in the country and it is unique program to foster mentorship opportunity between academic scholars and startups working in similar domain. First phase of the program was kickstarted through partnering with TERI, the Energy and Resources Institute, Regional Center for Biotechnology, Council on Energy, Environment and Water, and TERI School of Advanced Studies. Activities under are implemented and monitored by Ministry of Commerce and Industries. The last one is World First Thermal Battery Plant to be unveiled in Andhra Pradesh. The world first ever thermal battery plant owned by Bharat Energy Storage Technology Private Limited, it's simply called BEST, was inaugurated in Amaravati, Andhra Pradesh. It aims to create new energy storage form that is expected to have commercial applications. It also maintains low carbon footprint and less dependent on external factors like weather. BEST is planning to create a battery capacity of 1000 megawatt. The plant will begin its commercial operation from May 2019. Thermal battery is hailed as perfect alternative to non-renewable energy sources. It is considered to be even better than solar energy. Thank you, friends.